Hey everyone, Nate from Growers House here, and we just got the new Solar System 550 from California Lightworks in. And this light just came out recently. California Lightworks used to have, you know, the solar flare and the solar storm light. Now this is the solar system light, and I asked him, George, the owner of California Lightworks, you know, why the name solar system? So we got into some details about what California Lightworks is doing and how they're trying to push the envelope with regard to LEDs in the indoor growing industry, as most people see LEDs encroaching on the HID market and the ceramic linoleum halide market. And I think most people believe LED will be the primary light source and the one to go with eventually. We're just not sure exactly what day that'll be. But I think that California Lightworks is probably going to be one of the companies that's going to be there first. And this light probably being the most advanced to date. So let's go over it and show you why that is. So this light is actually, if you take a look at it, it's a 400 watt light at the wall. And it runs from 90 volts to 277 volt, and that's totally variable, so you can run on any voltage you want, like 120, 208, 240, 277. It really does not matter. This light will be able to handle all voltages. And they say that this one is about the equivalent of a 550 watt HID light. And this light is designed with, you know, quite a few different features in mind, including the one that was kind of pioneered by Gavita, which is the controllability of the fixture via these RJ11 cables that go have an in input and an output, which allow you to daisy chain up to 100 lights. So if you daisy chain up to 100 lights on one controller, you can affect their lighting cycle. And these, you know, the controller is just as smart as the Gavita controller, where you're able to do sunrise, sunset. You're actually able to do a little bit more. Since it's LED, you can affect the spectrum. So we can go over the reds, the whites, and the blues. And, you know, something that not a lot of people know about this, but the reason they call it the solar system is because California Lightworks told me they plan on having UVB and IR lights to kind of join the lineup, making it kind of a system, like a modular system. So whereas this light is your primary lighting source, California Lightworks wanted to have the option for people to have a UVB, a small supplementary UVB light that you can hook into your system wherever you want. So rather than having it attached to your fixture, if you want UVB or IR, infrared, every two lights, every three lights, or every other light, you can do that. And you can also connect it via those RJ11 cables so that you can use the controller to take care of all the fixtures. And another cool feature that California Lightworks told us about, which I'm not sure a lot of other controlling lights are able to do this, but you can easily checkerboard these fixtures if you'd like. Like a fixture can be turned off, for example, within a string of 100 lights, and it could be the 98th fixture, and the 99th and 100th fixture will still be working as long as that RJ11 cable is there. So you're able to turn off, you know, as many lights as you want, as long as they're daisy chained into each other. Whether on or off, doesn't really matter. The signal will keep on carrying on through the lights and keep affecting the ones that are even past it, from farther away from the controller. So that said, I mean, I wanted to go over this fixture also because, you know, this is probably one of the most price and like cost effective units on the market. This fixture was designed in a way that California Lightworks said that we need to take LEDs to the next, you know, to the next level, where like they actually start becoming a little bit more cost effective. So when they were designing this unit, everything was designed in such a way that it could be really high quality and at the same time bring down the cost. So their goal was, we want to make this light less expensive and still have the highest technology available, and then be able to increase the warranty. And they were able to do that with this fixture. I mean, this extruded aluminum and the UV resistant materials they use, you can use this in a greenhouse. None of the materials will fade, essentially. I mean, it has a special polycarbonate material that can stand up, and everything's UL certified. So any people that have facilities that are really large or you need UL certification, this will totally be able to be working in those. And you know, the price of this fixture came down to the point where I think it makes it a little bit more feasible to have it in a lot of these commercial spaces. I know this one, on a commercial scale, the price can get pretty can get pretty far down to the point where, you know, you're using three of these over a 4x8 area, and you'd be able to have a lot of light. I mean, you're talking about 400 watts at the wall, 550 watt equivalent. That's basically a 1650 watt equivalent over a 4x8 table with this light, and you'd be able to have probably some pretty insane growth. Plus, be able to change the spectrum to exactly what you want it to be if you're really that boutique grower who's looking to have that spectrum really give off certain characteristics or traits of your plants. So this might be one of the primary lights for the people that are really focused on quality and trying to build that modular system that California Lighthouse is building out currently. And you know, this is the 550 model, but I wouldn't be surprised if they came out with, you know, maybe something that was twice this strong and then half this strong. That's what they have often done in their lineup. If you look at the solar flare, like the 220 or the 110, and then they have the 440 and the 880. So here's the 550. I mean, you know, I would wouldn't be surprised if they have different model lineups that can help make that growing environment more modular for you. And for those people that are in greenhouses who are looking for supplemental light, if you look how small this thing is, it doesn't really cast a large shadow over your growing area, and that's why they designed it this way. So that, you know, if you want to make sure that you can grow in a greenhouse and be able to take care of your crop very easily. I mean, this thing is totally weather resistant, so don't worry about humidity damaging your light. It's very ready to go. So other than that, I want to bust out the controller and show it to you guys so you can see how it works, and then throw this guy under some light meters so we can see, you know, what kind of spectral readings this thing gives off, and also show off, you know, what kind of footprint it has over our 5x5 area. So let's get started. So here we are with the solar system controller, and it's pretty small. As you can see, it comes with a nice wall mount, and this thing is 3D printed, so jumping into the space age, as they say. So let's turn it on, and this is just the main setup screen, and you can see the time is in military time. The program is whatever you want to name, so you can name it like veg or flower propagation, you know, flower set A or flower set B. If you have different, you know, strains or plants, you can even name them. So it shows you right now the reds, whites, and blues are all at zero. If I jump into manual mode really fast, I can edit these with this big plus being increments of 10 and the small plus being increments of 1. Or I can just go 100% on, which is pretty awesome. So I'll just turn all of those on. That's 100%. If I wanted to, I could turn both of those off, and now I could just be using white light to look at my plants. And I could also hit view mode, which effectively does the same thing. It brings down all the whites so you can just take a quick look at your plants so they look natural. Look for any deficiencies or anything irregular in your plants. If we go back, I can go into the setup, and this thing really has a fair amount of options. Like if you go to, you know, set time and set calendar are pretty self-explanatory. You just jump in and set what time it is in military time. Edit programs is the part that I really want to touch base with you guys about, because here you can edit the steps. So most people will just do something like a on at this time, off at this time, with a sunrise and sunset of a certain amount of time. So right now this is going on at noon, off at 12:10, and with a 10 minute sunrise and sunset feature. So that means it'll take 10 minutes to go from zero intensity up to whatever intensity you have set up here. So what I could do is click there, change the intensity up to what I want, and maybe we'll go all the way with these ones. And then I can make this sunrise and sunset time a little bit shorter. So that means over the course of 5 minutes. And if I wanted to, I'll make that 2 more hours, hit save, and then go back to it. If I wanted to, I can even change how the lights change during, within that time span. And I can do that by going to advanced and then changing the steps. So there's step 1, step 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it actually goes all the way to step 20, which 20 is with off time right now. And you'll see whether they're active or not. So I can go and set any of these to what I want, essentially whatever I want. So going back to step 1, go plus 1, and then activate that. And then I just tell it what time I need to activate it at, which with this one,
1205, save, and edit steps. Cool, now it's set, and you can see the advanced turned red, which just means that I have more than just an on and off. And other than that, I mean, that's how the controller works. Like I said, up to 100 lights. It's pretty easy to use. And if you guys have any questions, please give us a call or send us an email. At that point, let's jump into some of the specs for the light so we can see how it performed in our battery of tests.
Okay, so let's jump into some of these spectral charts. Let's first start off with the nanometer wavelengths. And you can see that we put the chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B vertical lines in here so you can see how well this spectrum hits those peaks. And those peaks are really showing off if the light is most intense near those peaks, then that's the most efficient spectrums that the plant can use to absorb. So you want lights, if they're gonna have intensity, to be right around those vertical lines. And you can see that this light does between the 400 and 500 nanometers and the 600 to 700 nanometers, which the 600 to 700 is more of your flowering spectrum versus the 400 to 500 more of your vegetative spectrum. And you can see that the relative intensity is much higher in the flowering spectrum, and that's where you want more of the relative intensity to be. So the spectrum overall is designed very well in this LED. And let's move on to the PAR footprint so we can see how the light is dispersed from this unit. So in looking at these footprints, the thing that I was probably most interested in seeing was that, you know, this is a very rectangular light, and a lot of times with these rectangular lights, the footprint is very rectangular as well, which is good for some areas, but not great for others. And a lot of times people want more of a square kind of footprint. And I talked to California Lightworks about this, and they said that they designed the optics so that even though it's a rectangular light, it has a very square footprint. So that is actually shown pretty well in our footprints that we measured at 18, 24, and 36 inches above our 5x5. Now this light is really more of like what I would say like a 3x4 for flower and a 4x5 for veg. But when you look at it, I mean, I would say that the overall intensity is very much more like a square fashion versus some other LEDs we've tested, kind of like some of the kind, you know, L300, 450, 600, or the units from Lush Lighting. So even though it's a rectangular unit, very square footprint that's pretty uniform. And you know, in our testing, it came out 3.69 amps at basically 110, 120 volts, 406 watts at the wall. And this unit is pretty powerful for that amount of watts at the wall. And you can compare it to other units that we've also done this similar testing with. So other than that, this data should be linked below on our website if you want to comb through it a little bit more. And this is Nate from Growers House. Happy growing.